96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Juan McCartney is sponsored by Alive, Burger King, Commonwealth Bank, J.S. Johnson, Marco's Pizza, NUA Insurance Agents and Brokers, and Ron's Electric Motors.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to The Revolution here on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. My name's Juan McCartney. Good to have you with us. Okay, so yesterday we talked about this FTX situation, and I said I wanted to be very careful because I wanted to not paint anything in a particular light. And what a difference a day makes, because this situation looks really, 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 really bad. Here's how I approach life, or a certain aspect of life. I'm willing to change my viewpoint if I have new information. Better information. And yesterday's developments really do show that Sam Bankman-Fried is in a world of trouble. I'm going to read the story for you, and I'm going to be perfectly honest with you. What it looks like happened here, they send you to prison in the United States of America for less than what has occurred with FTX. That's how bad it is. And it's also bad for us because he is licensed here. And we are the regulator here. And it really does speak to what level of due diligence was done and who was really monitoring this situation. The head of the Securities Commission of the Bahamas has yet to answer our questions. I don't know why that is or how long she will maintain that posture or perhaps... She's being told not to speak to this, but this is a problem, and it falls on us as well. There's just no way we get out of it as a country. So I didn't have that position yesterday, but I do have that today. I'm going to read you the story from Chester Robards. What it appears to look like is, it looks like securities fraud. Like the old-fashioned kind, where you take on a bunch of debt, you bring in investors, you spend money you don't have, and then when it's time to cash in the chips, you don't actually have the resources to do it. And that's just straight up, that is securities fraud. All right, so, and there's some other stuff that looks wonky here as well. All right, so this is a story from Chester Robards. And I'm going to tell you how this impacts us in numerous ways. On the face of it, it maybe get even deeper. So this says Binance pulls out of FTX bailout deal. All right, so someone's trying to, they were going to bail FTX out, but they've pulled out. Binance is the world's biggest cryptocurrency exchange. And they've now stepped away. The Chester Robards writes, Binance, the world's largest cryptocurrency exchange, revealed yesterday via Twitter that it will not make good on its conditional intent to bail out Bahamian-headquartered cryptocurrency exchange, FTX, owned by Sam Bankman-Fried, who has reportedly filed for bankruptcy, according to many sources. Several news sites reported that the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission is now looking into the inner workings of FTX after it was announced on Tuesday that Bankman-Fried called Binance owner Changpeng Zhao, also known as CZ, for a bailout after there was a run on FTX's token, FTT, that left FTX in a liquidity crisis. When asked about the developing situation, FTX's Vice President of Communications and Corporate Social Responsibility, Valdez Russell, told this newspaper yesterday that the company is currently focused on the well-being of its employees and investors. At FTX, we're focused on the task at hand to protect our customers and do what is right for our employees and investors, said Russell. We recognize the enormity of this task and the impact that it will have locally, yet still we resolve to do what is right for our community. Calls to Attorney General Ryan Pinder and Executive Director of the Securities Commission of the Bahamas, Christina Roll, on the developing situation with FTX were not answered up to press time yesterday. Acting Prime Minister Chester Cooper told the Nassau Guardian that he has been briefed on the FTX situation, but could not say much on the matter. Cooper said, I've been briefed on the matter by the Attorney General. This is a matter for the regulators, and there are international implications. We have a well-established regulatory regime with a top-notch reputation in international financial services. I am constrained from commenting further, but I'm confident that the matter is in the sights of the relevant regulators. So in April, Prime Minister Philip Brave Davis officially opened the offices of FTX, explaining in his address during a ribbon-cutting ceremony that it is his hope that the domiciling of FTX in the Bahamas will be a catalyst for more fintech firms to open offices. Davis said during his remarks that companies like FTX want to be in a well-regulated, stable environment like ours, where continued growth and expansion are supported. Bankman-Fried said his company chose the Bahamas from a laundry list of countries because of its digital assets legislation, known as the Digital Assets and Registered Exchanges Act. Or DARE. During the groundbreaking for FTX's $60 million headquarters, Bankman-Fried said FTX searched the globe with a fine-tooth comb to find a well-regulated jurisdiction to set up shop. We sort of went country by country and crossed off the ones that required a license but could not grant one. We weren't sure where we'd end up. We sort of got word that one of them actually had already passed a cryptocurrency regulation regime, one of the only jurisdictions in the world to do so, and the few emissaries we had sent to check it out had a really, really good experience. That was the Bahamas. Halfway through the process of trying to figure out where we would be, the Bahamas sort of jumped all the way to the front. Bankman-Fried said the work that's been done by the Securities Commission and the government went a long way in helping FTX make the decision to move its company to this country. FTX also held one of the world's largest cryptocurrency and blockchain conferences called Crypto Bahamas at Bahamar this year in partnership with thought leadership group SALT. Bahamar recently hailed FTX as being good for the country and good for Bahamar. The future of Crypto Bahamas, which brought speakers like former British Prime Minister Tony Blair and former U.S. President Bill Clinton, now hangs in the balance. Crypto Bahamas 2023 has also been announced, and organizers plan to fill Bahamar to capacity with attendees. There is still no understanding of what FTX's possible collapse could mean for all of the commitments and investments the company and its team have made in the Bahamas, including a multi-million-dollar investment in a headquarters in Western New Providence. There's also speculation that there could be widespread damage to this country's reputation after FTX became the golden child for digital asset regulation in the Bahamas and the great hope for a big future in the digital assets industry in this country. Bankman-Fried shared these comments online Tuesday. He said, things have come full circle, and FTX's first and last investors are the same. We've come to an agreement on a strategic transaction with Binance for FTX. Our terms are working on clearing out the withdrawal backlog as is. This will clear out liquidity crunches. All assets will be covered one-to-one. This is one of the main reasons we've asked Binance to come in. It may take a bit to settle. We apologize for that. As of last evening, Newswire agency Reuters reported that Bankman-Fried told investors the company needs $8 billion to cover the shortfall caused by the number of withdrawal requests the company received in the past few days. So this is not only FTX just royally screwed. This has implications for the entire crypto market, and it also has implications for firms, Wall Street firms, that well-known, reputable Wall Street firms that invested in this company, that people are now looking at like they're crazy. So let's go. Let me tell you the latest what Bankman-Fried said. And again, I'm not calling for any particular outcome. People go to prison for this. I was trying to key you in to the enormity of what is occurring. When I say enormity, I don't mean in terms of just dollar value. At the end of the day, the New York Stock Exchange, I think the market cap was $8 trillion or something like that last year. At the end of the day, $8 billion is a drop in the bucket. But it's what it means for the market and for investors, all right? Because crypto's doing a robust business, all right? Like, okay, so I wouldn't really take payment in crypto. But if you have it and you can trade, you can make money, you know? Because people assign value to, like, people assign value to it. And it is what it is. Just like people assign value to baseball cards and, you know, antique clocks. But this has serious implications for the market. So let me deal with what Sam Bankman-Fried said today, and then we'll go from here. He says, one, I'm sorry. That's the biggest thing. I effed up and should have done better. Two, I also should have been communicating more very recently. Sure, yeah. Transparently, my hands were tied during the duration of the possible Binance deal. I wasn't particularly allowed to say much publicly, but of course it's on me that we ended up there in the first place. He said, three. Someone just sent me a text. I'm so sorry. Three, so here's an update on where things are. He says, this is all about FTX International. The non-U.S. exchange, FTX U.S. users are fine. Doubt that. So he's saying this is about FTX International, which I think he's talking about in the Bahamas. They're also in Antigua, but their headquarters is domiciled here. This says this is all about FTX International, the non-U.S. exchange. FTX U.S. users are fine. Treat all of these numbers as rough. There are approximations here. Four, FTX International currently has a total market value of assets / collateral higher than client deposits, moves with prices. But that's different from liquidity for delivery, as you can tell from the state of withdrawals. The liquidity varies widely from very to very little. Five, the full story here is one I'm still fleshing out every detail of, but as a very high level, I effed up twice. The first time, a poor internal labeling of bank-related accounts meant that I was substantially off on my sense of users' margins. I thought it was way lower. My sense before, leverage equals 0x, U.S. liquidity ready to deliver 24x, average daily withdrawals. Actual leverage 1.7x, liquidity 0.8x, Sundays withdrawals. Because, of course, when it rains, it pours, we roughly saw $5 billion of withdrawals on Sunday, the largest by a huge margin. Seven, And so I was off twice, which tells me a lot of things, both specifically and generally, that I was expletive at. And a third time, not communicating enough, I should have said more. I'm sorry, I was slammed with things to do and didn't give updates to you all. And so we are where we are, which sucks, and that's on me. I'm sorry. 9. Anyway, right now, my number one priority by far is doing right by users, and I'm going to do everything I can to do that, to take responsibility and do what I can. 10. So right now, we're spending the week doing everything we can to raise liquidity. I can't make any promises about that, but I'm going to try and give anything I have to if that will make it work. There are a number of players who are in talks with, letters of intent, term sheets, etc. We'll see how that ends up. 12, every penny of that and of the existing collateral will go straight to users unless or until we've done right by them. After that, investors, old and new, and employees who fought for what's right for their career and who weren't responsible for any of the F-ups. 13, because at the end of the day, I was CEO, which means that I was responsible for making sure that things went well. I ultimately should have been on top of everything. I clearly failed in that. I'm sorry. So what does this mean going forward? Well, there's a lot of it. Anyway, listen. Listen to me. Let me start at the beginning. So first of all, he says this is all about FTX International. The non-US exchange, FTX users are fine. That's nonsense. What are you talking about? Your US clients cannot make withdrawals. What do you mean they're fine? Your company, you file for bankruptcy. Your company is going to be liquidated as a result. You've spent your clients' money and clients and investors' money. And are unable to pay them back. You say, this is, see, I'd stop talking if I was you. So here's what you said you did. The first time, a poor internal labeling of bank-related accounts meant that I was substantially off on my sense of users' margin. I thought it was way lower. What? What are you talking about? A poor internal labeling of U.S. accounts? By the way, they say all his lawyers have quit the company. That's when you know that there's a real, real, real problem. Man, you are in deep, 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 deep trouble. Okay, so he has filed for bankruptcy, and someone says that someone's telling me they bet a lot of the property is not in FTX's name, and that's why he filed for bankruptcy. I don't think that's going to help him. All right, so here's, you file for bankruptcy. You have people's money, right? This is the simple process in the United States. You file for bankruptcy to try to protect your assets so that you don't have a feeding frenzy of everyone like putting liens on you and taking control of your property and your money and everything. So you file for bankruptcy so you can go through a structured process to pay your clients back, all right, if possible, and to see who has primacy of claim to whatever assets you do have, okay? When you file for bankruptcy in the United States of America, and there's different types of bankruptcies, but this is probably a Chapter 11, all right? And you, first of all, the first person who's going to lay claim to your stuff is the government. So the government of the Bahamas, the government of the U.S., because you're regulated and licensed by them. So those are the first people who are going to lay claim if you're involved in this sort of stuff. So they're probably going to freeze his bank accounts. They probably have already frozen them here. We have frozen them, more than likely. that's why the attorney general is talking about it now, because it's a legal matter now. All right. Or the attorney general has briefed Chester Cooper. He's not talking to us so far. All right. They're going to freeze your bank accounts here. They're going to freeze your bank accounts in the United States of America. Then you're going to have to disclose all of your assets everywhere on planet Earth, the moon as well, right? If you do not disclose, give the U.S. government full disclosure when you are filing for bankruptcy protection, you go to prison. It don't matter how rich you are. It don't matter how well connected you are. They will send you to prison. All right? They're going to freeze his assets, seize his property. Boy, I don't know how he stays. I don't know how he doesn't get indicted for this. And I'm not pulling. I'm just saying. You falsely reported the financial viability of your company while taking investors' money and trading in assets that that were really not fungible. Well, you couldn't back them 1-to-1. They're going to close his offices. Then they're going to seize his property. Hopefully, there's some sort of protection for the employees, hopefully. We'll see. All right, let's take a break. We'll come right back, and then we'll go from there.
How important collecting your money can be to the success of your business. Start your relationship with Fidelity today so that we can show you the many options available to you with our merchant services. From click and pay options online to merchant terminals and e-commerce options, we're here to help your business succeed. For more details, speak to one of our business development officers at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit our website at fidelitygroup.com or visit any of our branches. Fidelity, we're good
for you. If you were exposed to COVID-19, have symptoms, or traveled recently, get tested so that you can have peace of mind about your status. Just visit one of our convenient locations on New Providence at the University of the Bahamas or Golden Gates Plaza, weekdays 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and Saturdays 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. on Eleuthera at the Three Island Dock, Mondays through Thursdays 8 a.m. to 6 p.m., Fridays and Saturdays 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., and Sundays 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. on Exuma at the Regatta Park, weekdays 9 a.m. to 3 p.m., Saturdays 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Sundays 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. On Abaco at Maxwell Food Store, Mondays through Saturdays, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. The COVID-19 test results will be ready in 15 minutes, and the tests are free.
This message is brought to you by PAHO WHO and the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
What if I told you that the future is here? That is not some magical door we walk through, but a place we create. It's home. The place where you can download a two-hour movie in seconds and stay connected to loved ones even when traveling far from home. Where internet moves at lightning speeds, smoother and more reliable than anything you've ever seen. This future-proof technology can take you to worlds that you can only imagine. The future is here. The future is home. The future is Alive Fiber.
I used to think of the bank as my personal ATM machine. If I wanted a new car, new furniture, a weekend trip to Miami, no problem. Just max out the credit card or top up my loan. I was a big baller.
until I realized that 75% of my salary was going to pay back all those loans. Fidelity's personal financial coaching was the best solution. Fidelity gave me a plan with a debt consolidation loan that has a built-in savings that pays 5% interest. I now only have one low monthly payment, plus money in my pocket. Give Fidelity Bank a call at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit any of Fidelity's locations or visit a website at fidelitygroup.com.
You do coffee your way. Double shot, decaf, cappuccino.
Light roast, Colombian, no milk.
You do vacations your way.
Hiking boots, tent, mountains.
Five-star hotels and theater.
And now you can do insurance your way.
Online.
Email.
Chat.
WhatsApp.
Or in branch. For home, car, travel, boat, or business insurance, do it anyway with NUA Insurance agents and brokers. Visit NUAinsurance.com, call, or stop by a branch today.
At Ron's Electric Motors, they repair and rewind all major brands of electric motors, including water pumps, generators, and the generator's back end, welding machines, electric lifts, air compressors, battery chargers, and more. They're equipped to handle up to 850 kilowatts and rewind up to 450 horsepower motors. They're conveniently located on the corner of Wolf and Clarence Roads and are open weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturdays till noon. They offer 24 hours emergency assistance. You can reach them on
2423-564-9. Good afternoon, Bahamas. Welcome back to The Revolution here on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. So Bankman-Fried has filed for bankruptcy, or FTX has filed for bankruptcy. It's in need of $8 billion. Okay, so, you know, I'm not going to weep for the poor billionaire, but this already has implications for us, as Chester Cooper said, it's got international implications. These guys are headquartered here. And let me say this, you know, and I do have questions about the due diligence. I do have questions about the regulatory oversight. But this guy apparently swung everyone. And I am concerned about the local employees. It's you don't want people to be dangling out here out of work. This guy swung everyone. Tom Brady. He had Tony Blair here. He had Bill Clinton here. He had Anthony Scaramucci. Mooch was here. Huge players in the crypto space. He had the second largest cryptocurrency exchange on Earth. And yes, there's risk involving investment, but you can't cook the books, man. You can't talk about poor internal labeling a bank account. That's insanity, what you're saying. You can't claim that the U.S. arm is fine, but only the international arm is impacted. What are you talking about? That makes zero sense to me. Maybe someone else can explain that to me. Zero sense that makes. The international arm is fine. Come on, man. The U.S. arm is fine. Only the international arm has an issue. That makes little to no sense to me. All right? You were saying that you had... Okay, so if the U.S. arm is fine... See, Sam, you're going to have to stop now. I know you was supposed to be a genius and all this. If the U.S. arm of FTX is fine, why has your Alameda website gone offline? Why can your U.S. clients not get their money back if the U.S. arm is fine? Your whole house of cards is coming crashing down, and you're still out here talking like it's all going to be okay. The Securities and Exchange Commission is investigating your loans to back other cryptocurrencies, which is going to cause them to now crash as well. And your FTT is, at the moment, worthless. This is a very serious situation. I'd stop talking if I was you. The Federales, well, I know who gets first dibs. I guess locally, the local regulator will get first dibs since he's here. And has to answer this. Christina Roll has to speak to this. This is a major problem. This is like when, what the hell is it? Clico, right? Went belly up. And money and da 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 da. No, they're not, man. Like, you don't have the money to cash your customers out. Simple. And no one's willing to back you. Binance won't do it. This is a serious, serious problem. We got to call. Let's do a call. And then we'll leave. Do text messages, etc. And I'm not pulling. I'm not wishing anything bad on anyone. But this is... You're here spinning dreams, man. And you sold people this bill of goods, and now you can't back it up. And you're out here talking about it's fine. Only the international arm is... What does that even mean? You know what I mean? What does that mean? Give me a break here. Let's take the call, and then we'll... Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
How you doing, Juan?
Hey, I'm great. How's it going?
So you're trying to say if it was you, you would lawyer up.
He better lawyer up. And shut up. Those two.
See, Juan, we really should check to see if you got a couple dollars before you come and start talking to us. You know, put up or shut up. That's my rule. Don't tell me you coming to do something. You ain't got no money to show me. Remember that movie, Show Me the Money?
Yep.
Yeah. So, you know, but the question is, a lot of people asking, so this is the end of crypto, Bitcoin, Ethereum, whatever, right? They said no. See, if a big Canadian bank closes in Toronto and the Bahamas, right?
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't mean that my gold coin is now valueless.
Yeah, Bitcoin they're okay for now. They're gonna bottom out at some point. The market's
inside
free
trading,
fall.
You know, if somebody would have grabbed that last night at 15K, today they would have made $2,000 or so on each coin.
Mm-hmm.
That's inside trading, and you know that it's illegal to do certain things in a fiat world, but in a crypto world, you can have the richest guy say, "Hey, I accept this payment for my car." And it go from $40,000 to $60,000, and you bet on that rise.
But what you cannot do in no world,
yes,
is misrepresent your ability to pay your clients.
Yes, and see, where this actually became a problem is this now moved between fiat and crypto.
Correct.
So now you have all these regulators involved. What the richest guy in the world did with his car company, that had nothing to do with paper money. That was in the crypto space, even though it was inside trading cryptoly, if that's a word. But you see, we need to have a real conversation about what happened, because a lot of people, like you said, a lot of people lose money, but quite a few people made a bunch of money too, betting on that going down, hedging. And a lot more, if they knew it was going to happen, waited till it bottomed out at around 15K and dropped some money on that, and they made some stupid money. You realize if you're a guy that's worth $20 billion, right? Mm-hmm. Allegedly, and you take $1 billion and drop on crypto the $15,000 mark last night, yesterday. This morning you woke up $2,000 per coin richer on $1 billion. You could be the richest man in the world and don't be talking, because no regulator would know you got that money. But, you know, the space of owning crypto and having it on maybe a hardware wallet like Trezor and going peer-to-peer instead of putting it in these banks or these crypto exchanges, those are the people who got wounded yesterday. But the people who had their coin secured on a piece of hardware, they survived. Now, I'm looking at the clock.
I mean, people who had FTT can do nothing with it. They, you know.
No, but if Google this, Trezor, T-R-E-Z-O-R. If you had a Trezor and you had your one Bitcoin or your 1,000 Bitcoins there in that space, you weren't at any of these exchanges. I wouldn't call the name, but you know them.
Okay. All right.
So
it's
like you having your gold coin in your hand instead of in someone's bank.
Gotcha. So I got to go to the break, man.
Dude.
All right.
Have a good one.
We'll be back. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to The Revolution here on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. My name is Juan McCartney. Good to have you with us. Nino Bankman-Fried and FTX bought up a lot of property. Certainly in Albany, I understand, Lyford Key as well. And a lot of people who are in the crypto space have rented a lot of high-end properties on Western New Providence, a lot of FTX guys. Look, if you, hopefully, y'all didn't get paid in FTT, and they, I don't be into no one running out with me. You know, I can give you some Bitcoin or some Ethereum or I could pay you in a non-fungible token, man. You better give me some cash, bro. Government legal tender is what I want. A sand dollar. I'll do some sand dollar. That's about it. But this is why people are distrustful of the digital, the sand dollar as well. Even though it is money backed by the central bank, people keep hearing these horror stories about, getting screwed in the crypto space. Some people were paid in FTT. No, man. You can't pay me in no FTT. All right. You can't pay me in the FTT. I'm so sorry. Or Bitcoin. Not never. Me? Cash. I want cash, bro. I need something. Cash. I'll take something we could trade that I know I actually could have a hold of, you know? All right. I need some hard currency. But this is kind of the problem with crypto is that, and I'm not down in crypto, yada, yada, I don't want to get paid in it for certain. All right? But the problem with crypto is at the end of the day, I want to be sure I can cash out, you know? With actual money, the government says they will back it, and that's why the central banks of the world, you know, are able to function. And so ultimately, the Bahamas government will back the Bahamian dollar supported by our foreign reserves, and then the U.S. government will back the U.S. dollar, which is the world's reserve currency. Right. Let me see here. I wonder if y'all got paid an FTD for Drew. This says, as a financial services practitioner of over 30 years, I am beyond disappointed, re the silence by the Securities Commission of the Bahamas, the regulator. It is unacceptable. I agree. I agree. Okay, so let me show you what the Securities Commission said after the DARE Act was implemented. So this is frequently asked questions. So what are some of the factors the commission will consider when reviewing an application for registration? The Securities Commission of the Bahamas, when considering whether to approve an application for registration, will need to be satisfied that the applicant is incorporated, established, or registered under any law of the Bahamas, is fit and proper, and has sufficient capacity and resources to conduct an activity provided for under DARE, which is the Digital Assets Registration Act. Further, applicants must demonstrate that it has appropriate and sufficient controls to perform its functions and manage its risks, e.g. fraud and market abuse, that it has the ability to meet solvency standards and levels of capital as may be prescribed by regulations, and has designed a digital asset framework that takes into account key components such as technology and security, governance, scalability, identified risk framework, and data protection and storage, among other things. Okay? Let me go. Further, applicants must demonstrate that it has sufficient controls to perform its function and manage its risks, e.g. fraud and market abuse, that it has the ability to meet solvency standards and levels of capital as may be prescribed by regulations. Okay, so FTX does not have the ability to meet solvency standards and levels of capital. FTX has not had sufficient controls to perform its functions and manage its risks, apparently. And that is what the Securities Commission of the Bahamas is supposed to be monitoring. And, I mean, they're all very nice people, I'm sure. But we're not just going to shirk accountability here. That we're not speaking about this, that we're not hearing anything from them, is disconcerting. All right? Quite. We got a phone call. Let's do it. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution. Good afternoon. Welcome. Are you there? Hello. One more time. Good afternoon. Nope. Okay. Let's do this. Juan, when I first heard about FTX, I was skeptical. Something was just not kosher. There's a saying, when something seems too good to be true, chances are it is too good to be true. Says, wow, he sounds like the lady that messed up my Wendy's order. No real sense of accountability. I know, if only this was our Wendy's order, that we didn't get cheese, and when we specifically asked for it, if only it were that simple. It says, go back to October 2021. FTX describes our government and regulators as global leaders, innovators, and the world is jealous of the robust legislation they've drafted and implemented. if that was not a red flag, he talking about my good government? Meanwhile, FTX runs its Ponzi scheme under our noses while the U.S. Securities and Exchange has been investigating their activity for months now. Embarrassing, to say the least. Yeah, yesterday I felt like, we'll be okay, but getting all the information now is my view has changed. Juan, if this buddy think he ain't end up like Madoff, he tell a lie. I mean, people have gone to prison for this sort of thing. Says Juan, I trade in cryptocurrency and can tell you that FTX was always a red flag for me, as in doing my research on its white paper and corporate structure. SBF and FTX had no CFO. Now listening to him speak, it's all I. Right. Says everyone said FTX and crypto so safe. In the end, if they're controlled by humans who can make mistakes or do deceitful things, I never trusted all the huge fanfare over this company. A lot of the cryptos, a lot of the people who I know who deal in crypto say, this they have gotten screwed, and it's crashing the market, but there's going to be opportunity when it rebounds. It says, where are the books held? Is there any possibility that our security commission missed the ball? This is a problem for our securities commission and our government, without question to me. OMG, all about FTX International, off on user margins. Yeah, cap. What are you talking about, dog? He said that too lightly. Margins are the whole game. They determine what money can be lent to clients and what cash has to be held in the bank. Correct. Brave Davis needs to shake his people up. We're too dazzled by people with money. Why does he keep saying, who is his risk manager? They should be getting these margin reports every single day. Juan, I'm seriously afraid for this country. I said yesterday that the Securities Commission put out a statement that was just too glowing about this new industry and its implications for the Bahamas and Bahamians. They completely failed to point out how volatile this thing was. That's their role. Fiduciary, not cheerleader. Yeah, you're right. And I'm not trying to by any means demonize the Securities Commission. I'm just saying I am stunned by their silence. It says, make no mistake, investors don't come here because we have strong regulatory laws. That's a fairy tale. Says the government really needs to be wise and thorough when dealing with these companies on the Bahamian people's behalf. What's up? Says filing for bankruptcy means you're not okay, Bulla. All the glitters ain't gold and photo ops don't cut it. Says it looks like his Merlion is about to spill some beans. Yeah, I saw he saying he made payments and stuff. Says we get swing. Digital Ponzi scheme. Here's how bad it is, right? So CZ, who was mentioned in the article, he had $2 billion worth of FTT. He won't back the company to get his money back. That's how bad it is. Before he fool with that, he'll lose that FTT. Says Juan, Sam will be just like Elizabeth Holmes. Poor internal labeling is the term used when stealing. Says Sam, swing them just like how Elizabeth Holmes did to others. Yeah, and I don't want to convict the man before anything's happened, but this is wild. Wild, wild, wild. It's my poor Solana coin. Yeah, Solana was backed by SBF too, right? I feel like a grandpa saying, back in my day, $130 was a good buy on Solana. Now it's worth $16. RIP. This says, can we just call Sam Blankman a complete moron? Okay, jeez. Some heavy words. It says, if it was one of ours who did this, And using expletives, we would have said the worst. What protection of employees if this ship sinks? Please explain. Listen, this is a problem. Let me show you something, right? So, huge companies, right? So, I mean, FTX ain't no big dog compared to like Amazon or a Google or Alphabet, you know, or Apple. But the way these companies, and I do wonder about this, the way a lot of these companies attract employees is by offering them stock options, right? And so that's a normal practice. So the guys who, so who's the dude who runs Disney? Bob Chapek, right? Chapek, the reason they bring these CEOs on is because they give them stock. So your skin in the game is that you want to raise the stock price. That's your bottom line. That's how the board functions. We'll give you stock if you need to raise the stock price because your own future is vested in it. So Bob Iger, the guy who was there before, by the time he cashed out, right, his stock was worth a couple $100 million, right? That's how this works. Amazon, when they want to hire you or whatever like that, they'll be like, we'll give you 5 shares of Amazon and plus your salary, rah, rah, rah. All right, and that's your retirement plan right there. I'm wondering if he was if they were paying people in FTT. You know, because it seems like a normal corporate practice. I'm getting some shares. I have the opportunity. Right. See, that's the thing. You don't want to be, you know, like short-sighted and be like, oh, I don't want none of that. And you miss the boat and then be like the people who started work. This guy who was sweeping the floor at Microsoft when it first started ended up being worth $400 million by the time he retired, you know? And you don't want to be like, oh, I don't want none of that. Microsoft stock, nobody. I don't want to get paid. So you don't want to miss the opportunity, but this stuff is risky, man. Let me see here. It says, I was telling you this yesterday, Juan, but look now. Yeah, I mean, I don't know who it was telling me. Someone was saying that this is a problem, and I was like, I think it'll be okay for us. And looking at it, I'm like, this is a problem. Says, I was telling you this yesterday, Juan, but look now. This country facilitated this guy ventures. Once he stays in the Bahamas, he'll be straight because I'm sure plenty of Bahamian politicians. He's well protected. Plus, he's Jewish, so he's safe. Our nation is working with him. You Jewish? They send Jewish people to prison, straight up. Madoff was Jewish, prison. What's the other guy? Back in the junk bond. Michael Milken was it? Jewish, prison. Think SBF was sent here to kill our economy. One economic hitman. I wouldn't say he'd be killing our economy. Matter of phone calls, do it. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Good morning. Good afternoon, Warren.
Hey, what's happening?
Now, I'm happy he didn't set up shop here yet. I was going to buy some of his coins. Let's say Warren, he's a marketing genius. We didn't heard of him till he gave Mickey Arison $44 million to put FTX on the heat, right?
Okay.
The weirdest company is that have all this cash. He gave Mickey Arison on the heat $144 million for 10 years to use FTX. Then like he don't live large. He live in a condominium. Him and like 5 guys look at the screen all day. But during the summer, he bought some failing companies. He bought BlockFi cryptocurrency and Voyager. I was like, he have excess cash. Then during the summer, he bought 56 million shares of Robinhood. He spent $700 million in cash.
Mm-hmm. But that wasn't his cash?
Yeah.
That was his investors' money.
Yes, but that made his name go up. Like, he have all this cash. People probably bought more from him. But everybody was broke. But he was floating around in plenty cash. Then, And then, like, what caused him? What caused the people to start taking the money out of FTX? That's the one right there. Why was there a run on FTX? People have angst. Because as far as I know, FTX was sound. As far as I was concerned, but he that overdid it when he spent so much cash, and now he don't have it, and he don't have it to pay back. And now he have a company called Alameda. Alameda owe FTX $10 billion. And then, man, there are companies in companies.
Yeah, it's a web of...
We want your American company, too. He wouldn't sell them that because that have billions of dollars in it for the American taxpayers. I guess he feel like if he pay off the Americans, he wouldn't go to jail.
He's not paying off anyone.
But the American company have money in it.
How the American company can have money in it and the Americans can't cash out FTT? Explain that to me.
Why he did not put it on the market when Beyonce?
I don't know all that, but that makes sense to you that the American company have money, but the American FTT owners can't cash out.
Who owns the 8% of Robinhood? Which company owns that?
I don't know all that.
In May of this year, he spent $700 billion in cash. But he just came here a year ago, so we can get all the blame.
Okay, I'm not saying that we're terrible people. What I'm saying is we need to examine our regulatory regime and our oversight of this in order to ensure that this is not something that happens with frequency. And we should perhaps be thankful that, and this has happened in other jurisdictions, South Korea, like I said, Binance is owned by a Chinese guy, right? You can't trade cryptocurrency in China. You go to jail. Or Hong Kong now, right? South Korea guy made off with billions of client funds, and he's currently on the run now. And he's somewhere in Europe, you know? So these things, the reason we have regulatory regimes is to fend off these sorts of things, all right? Things do slip through the cracks, but we need to understand what has happened here. Does FTX have a CFO? Does FTX have a local compliance officer like every other trade regime and securities regime in this country is supposed to have? These are questions. Who is FTX's compliance officer? Can someone answer that for me? Okay? You go to, you check with CFAL. There's a clear compliance officer, CFO. All right? They would have had to, does FTX have a local bank account since it is domiciled here? Who's monitoring that? And are the compliance officers at any local bank monitoring what's happening with FTX or have been monitoring? Y'all call me when I deposit money a penny over what was expected when I signed up the account. All right? Does FTX still have local assets here? What's going on with those bank accounts, those assets? There are questions to answer, all right? So, and we have to understand that this is serious stuff. And not hearing from the Securities Commission is a problem, all right? And the Bahamas still has here's the thing, right? Our reputation, okay, is what is valuable here. Our reputation. That's what we're trying to protect. That's why we set up an embassy in Brussels and then put a $19,000 rug in the residence, okay? Our reputation is what we want to check. That's why we fight tooth and nail to get off these gorillas. That's why we have 7,000 people in government working daily to make sure that we're checking off every box. Ryan Peter just talked about it. Halkey just talked about it. We got 40 different levels of administration to make sure that we protect our reputation. That's why the Securities Commission exists, so that the loom don't come here and suck up all y'all money. That's what it's for. All right? So we got to make sure that they're working to protect our reputation. That and protect our money. Okay? Protect our reputation, protect our money. All right, we got to go to a break. We'll be right back.
Here we go. J.S. Johnson Insurance agents are the best. Reliable service, we've been on the scene, protecting since 1919. J.S. Johnson Insurance has the best. Always, you're always calling me. J.S. Johnson Insurance, peace of mind.
Breakfast just got better at Wendy's. Introducing the Breakfast Biggie Bag. Enjoy a double sausage muffin with two square sausage patties, a freshly cracked egg, and cheese served on a toasted English muffin, a medium waffle fries, and an orange juice for only $5.25, fat inclusive. Add an apple pie for just $1 more.
Say what?
At Wendy's, better breakfast is all day. Offers valid in participating locations. Wendy's, different inside and out.
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
Okay, class, let's begin today's history lesson. Ancient civilization used to visit stadiums to watch musicians perform. It was called a live concert.
Teacher, what year was that?
Researchers believe it was around 2019. Normal life feels like a long time ago. As things return to normal, remember, it is essential to be fully immunized against all vaccine-preventable diseases like COVID-19, rubella, polio, hepatitis, mumps, and influenza. This message is brought to you by PAHO WHO, the Ministry of Health and Wellness, the Caribbean Development Bank, the Government of Canada, and the United States of America.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM.
Welcome back to The Revolution here on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. This says, Warren Buffett was right. This crypto stuff is a bubble. It's bursting. This is Juan. He's probably going to end up in a cell next to Bernie Madoff. Boy, I don't know. I don't know. This don't look good. I don't see how he escapes criminal charges. Good day, Mr. McCartney. I know this is off topic, but have you heard anything about the Clico situation, please? I haven't heard anything about Clico in ages. I could double check, but that's been, you know, well over a decade. I don't know if that's ever going to be resolved, unfortunately. This is good afternoon. I know this sounds crazy, but I never trusted that guy ever since I saw him show up at that press conference with shorts and sandals. So I always sensed that something was not all the way kosher with this company. The amounts of money being spent and donated in the early stages of an FTX presence in the Bahamas was insane. Yeah, you, because I hear it was Lang who was saying either yesterday or earlier in the week that I don't want to misquote him, but if he was saying that if he sees you coming here before you actually doing business and you throwing money around, da, 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 it kind of raises a red flag. You know what I mean? Like, I can see if you set up here and you're doing a robust business and then you're like, okay, let's do some community initiative. But when you come talking about, oh, here's some treats and goodies here, there, everywhere, everyone, da, 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 and you haven't really set up shop yet, that you do look at that. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution. Hello, good afternoon. Hello, are you there? Nope, okay. Another call, okay. Good afternoon, welcome to the revolution.
Hey, Vaughn, what's up, brother?
Hey, I'm good, how's it going?
I am great, man.
Awesome.
You got a particular caller who calls your talk show, who basically calls every talk show, very intelligent gentleman. Mm-hmm. And he always talking, encouraging basically his words, and so many words about this cryptocurrency and this Bitcoin and sand all the boy, listen, you're a raw born bohemian. We are used to paper, as time in this time in this age, we either deal with we either have debit cards or credit card or Visa card. Ain't nobody in the majority of bohemians. You do a survey and ask them if they had any Bitcoin, sand dollar, or anything like that.
But see, the problem is that they've confusing the Bitcoin with the sand dollar, and they haven't done a good job of public education with that.
Okay, so the people tie in all of those, and especially how this where they find out about this gentleman, that's even worse. Mm-hmm. So it could be a lot of resistance from a lot of people, and guess what? At the end of the day, as I understand that, this whole thing, there is no insurance on that, like on your bit, like on what they dealing like. That type of coins and different things. Not like when you have money, you have insurance on it. People rob you or take it from you. So that's a lower situation.
Yeah,
we as Bahamians, like I say, paper, brother, or God.
Right. I appreciate you. All right.
Yeah.
Thank you, Dan. And this is the thing. You want it. So the finance world is a lot of it is based on faith, right? Your investment in a company is based on faith. You want to look at the balance sheet and everything like that, but companies do crash. Look at Bear Stearns, you know what I mean? That what they were doing with the mortgages, you know? Companies do crash, so a lot of this is based on faith. And you have to, people have to have faith in the regulatory framework. People have to have faith in the strength of the government. When they talk about, when the United States government talks about the full faith and credit of the United States, that is their primary concern, because their whole thing hinges on the economy. If people lose faith that these are sound investments in cryptocurrency, then it's a problem, you know? And as far as Bahamians go, I do understand that, and it's a lot of people need to see their money, all right? So when I go take my little $50, right, the First Caribbean, and put it in there, I ain't no back room where First Caribbean goes, here's your money, it's right here, we got the $50, right? It's all electronic transactions going on, everything like that, and it is cash. And the cash ain't, you can't eat it. It's just that the government backs it, right? So you watch The Wire, right? You ever seen the episode when Marlo Stanfield said he was a drug dealer in Baltimore, and he told him, I have a problem. He went to another drug dealer and he said, I have a problem. And the other drug dealer was like, oh, what is it? And he's like, I have too much money. And he was like, what do you mean? He's like, he has like a houses like just filled with $100 bills and money from his drug enterprises. And he doesn't, he's running out of places to keep it. And the guy's like, Joe, he's like, you know, you got to put it in the bank, yada, yada, yada. And so they go through this network of establishing a charity and yada, yada, yada. And the guy gave him a check. And he's like, what's this? He's like, it's your money. He's like, I ain't into all that. And so he was like, I want to go see my money, right? And the guy says, okay, you want to get a passport, right? So he gets the passport, then he goes down to some Caribbean country, right? And he goes to the bank, and he's on at the teller, and he's like, hey, y'all got my money in there? I want to see my money. So his people gotta understand, like, these things are in a system of trade checks and balances, you know? But it ain't nothing like having hardcore cash in your hand. That's what I mean, I don't want cash, but I want actual regular money. Yeah, properly regulated. It says, Graham is misdirecting. Having an FTT token outside of FTX will not shield you. The fact is that your FTT token is practically worthless now. Exactly, yeah. That's the danger of crypto coins. The value is too volatile to be used in place of cash, and it should only be considered a high-risk speculative investment. Yeah, like I say, if you got a couple dollars you ain't tripping on, if you're living life so well that you got one, 4 or 5 grand you could play around with, you get into crypto space and, you know what I mean? Right, exactly. Right, correct. It says, hi, Juan, I've not considered any investment in Bitcoins because I'm not satisfied of their security. Additionally, FTX was giving away money like it was dirt for months, like it was dirt months ago, being new to the Bahamas. I wondered who was making those decisions and where all that money was coming from. I am saddened by their financial position and wish them well. It says, wait, what? Jews don't go to jail? How can I convert? Stay right there. But Jews don't go to jail. Stay right there. Plenty of them in jail right now, buddy. At the end of the day, they ain't watching that. Juan, as Perry Christie would have said, this is a teachable moment. This wasn't Allison Maynard Gibson's daughter, one of the financial officers at FTX. I believe she had a position at FTX, yeah. Says, Juan, wait till you hear the Bahamians who are in bed with FTX. Boy, I don't know. Apparently, FTX is one of, I don't recall this bank's name. It's an offshore bank in the Bahamas, one of their biggest clients. That may be true. It says, FTX has an attorney here. It's the former attorney general. That's public. Is that true or false? Yeah, I mean, she, up to last report, Allison Maynard Gibson is FTX's attorney or her law firm, you know. And I'm not saying anyone in the Bahamas did anything, any Bahamian did anything wrong, but it raises concerns that this has occurred with FTX and they are headquartered here. And we really should have, we need to have transparency to like what was done properly, what wasn't done, how did this evade scrutiny, XYZ, because he did get by the US regulators up to this point. You know what I mean? It says, based on your theory, do you think the football player spilled the beans that crumbled the umpire? Football player? Oh, Tom Brady. Tom Brady has a problem in that he invested a lot of money in FTX, as well as his ex-wife. I mean, Tom Brady will be okay. Yeah, his NFL salary is $30 million a year, so he'll be. Nah, he might got to keep playing. Ain't Tom Brady got another 5 years in him? He probably got to keep playing, two-way. Yeah, right, exactly. And ESPN wanted to hire him? Oh, Fox. Fox is going to pay him $50 million a year. Okay, yeah, he'll be fine. Brady will be fine. This says, Juan, this was so predictable and obvious regarding FTX. Why do you think FTX left Singapore and came to the Bahamas? Plus, FTX had Anthony Scaramucci, an own grifter and swindler. Look how you're talking about the Mooch, man. The Mooch is a respected attorney. To promote FTX a few months ago at a conference in Bahamar by special invitation only. Yeah, and someone was telling me we shouldn't just outright down the Bahamas. And I'm not doing that. I'm just calling for transparency. All right? We have many companies who do a lot of business here. All right? says, from day one, I had my doubts are either regulators have the expertise to effectively monitor this type of business. I want it's that same thing with that ramming guy dealing with. I don't know what that means. It says, who cares about cheating Tom Brady? Tom Brady ain't no cheater. What y'all talking about? Deflategate? Why he can't? The ball was a little too. he couldn't grip it good. And a little too much air was in it. That's all. Everything is cheating to y'all. All right, we gotta go to a break. We'll be right back.
Double shot decaf cappuccino.
Light roast Colombian no milk.
You do vacations your way.
Hiking boots, tent, mountains.
Five-star hotels and theater.
And now you can do insurance your way.
Online.
Email.
Chat.
WhatsApp.
Or in branch. For home, car, travel, boat, or business insurance, do it anyway with NUA Insurance agents and brokers. Visit NUAinsurance.com, call, or stop by a branch today.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
We know how important collecting your money can be to the success of your business. Start your relationship with Fidelity today so that we can show you the many options available to you with our merchant services. From click and pay options online to merchant terminals and e-commerce options. We're here to help your business succeed. For more details, speak to one of our business development officers at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit our website at fidelitygroup.com or visit any of our branches.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
Burger King wants you to ride into the holidays in style with a brand new 2022 BYD Han all-electric sedan from Easy Car Sales. It's as easy as 1, 2, 3. Just upgrade your favorite combo for one ticket or double your chances with a King Combo or triple your chance to win with the purchase of a BK Family Deal. It's electric at Burger King this holiday where you get the chance to win a 2022 BYD Han EV sedan when you upgrade your combo at Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
If you were exposed to COVID-19, have symptoms recently, get tested so that you can have peace of mind about your status. Just visit one of our convenient locations on New Providence at the University of the Bahamas or Golden Gates Plaza, weekdays 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and Saturdays 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. On Eleuthera at the Three Island Dock, Mondays through Thursdays 8 a.m. to 6 p.m., Fridays and Saturdays 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., and Sundays 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. On Exuma at the Regatta Park, weekdays 9 a.m. to 3 p.m., Saturdays 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Sundays 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. On Abaco at Maxwell Food Store, Mondays through Saturdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. The COVID-19 test results will be ready in 15 minutes, and the tests are free.
This message is brought to you by PAHO WHO and the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Revolution here on Guardian Radio. Been a hell of a week, eh? Gotta say. Okay, so the takeaway from all that has occurred leaves us with the following lesson, which is that Prime Minister Philip Brave Davis can't leave the country anymore. Okay? So, since the Prime Minister has been out of the country, one of the last times he left the country, a storm came. All this happened when he came here. Everything is go down. So, since the Prime Minister's been in Egypt, we have had a hurricane come. We have seen the collapse of the sale of the Grand Lucayan to Electra America Hospitality Limited. And now FTX has imploded. And I think what is clear is that the Prime Minister Brave Davis, cannot leave here for any extended period of time anymore. Anymore. Okay. I understand now what the reference was. That's fine. I'm not going to go through that. It says, tell your Greek Bahamian boy to comment on this, please. Theo, yeah, Theo. I need to talk to Theo to see what's happening. It says, great show as usual. Y'all don't know Brave going to Universal Studios and Disney World now. No more leaving town for you, sir. Things work better when you're around, I guess. I don't know. It's just but Cooper says the regulators are looking at it. It would have been nice to have said to have heard something to make sure they're on top of it. But so clearly the regulators are investigating locally what has occurred. Enterprises do fail. Banks often fail. Well, I don't want to say often. Banks do fail. Enterprises fail. Huge corporate enterprises often go out of business, you know. Is there a Kmart anymore? You know what I mean? Like, it happens. But we just got to be very careful about protecting people's money. And it's something that we're very good at in the Bahamas. And we want to ensure that there's still that faith in our system. Okay? So we just need to understand what has happened. That's all. And it's no, it's the fault lies with Sam Bankman-Fried. Okay? Not with the Bahamas, essentially, but with Sam Bankman-Fried. Okay? It says, Juan, climate change is serious. Did you see in front of Nesbitt yesterday, the ocean is coming to us? Let the PM travel on the people's business. I mean, I'm just being facetious. If it were me, I would have came back home. No, if I heard there was a hurricane coming, that's just me. But I don't mind him dealing with what he's dealing with. So, let me see here. Hold on. This is Juan, who heads the Securities Commission here, Christina Roll. So we'd like to hear from her or, you know, anyone at the commission. I think it's important. Juan, Kmart, Freeze? What's Freeze? Yeah, Toys R Us gone out of business, so no one's immune to going out of business. I mean, it's exactly right, you know? Businesses collapse, enterprises collapse, hell, governments collapse. You know, look at the Arab Spring. You know, it happens. There's no 100% guarantee of anything, but we want to make sure that we have checks and balances in place. And so we need to understand how the entire thing occurred. And I think it's nonsense of Bankman-Fried to go, the U.S. FTX is fine. That's not how this works, right? So Clico Bahamas wasn't the parent company of Clico, right? Clico elsewhere underwent a series of failures, and it impacted all the clients here. And many people have yet to get their money back, right? And you want to make sure that you have trust and faith. So when we come here and we go, when people come here and go, okay, well, invest in the port, yada, 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 people are going to look at the business plan. They're going to look at, okay, there's the growth of the enterprise and how that's going to work out over the next year, their ability to pay people back and pay back at a particular rate of interest, all right? When you look at our own sovereign credit rating, it's currently non-investment grade status at Moody's and S&P, all right? And they're looking at the ability of the government to service its debts. They're looking at investments carry risk, all right? All investments. So Moody's is saying, we're going to take these factors into account, we're going to scrutinize everything, and the government kicks open the door and says, we want you to come in, right? Moody's isn't forcing themselves to come to the Bahamas. We're asking them to come here. We're asking S&P to come here. Please look at this and review so that when we put a bond offering out on the international market or the local market, people have confidence in our ability to service that debt. All right? So due diligence, compliance, these things are important. We are happy to have the OECD and the FATF come here and look at what we're doing so that there is faith that we can maintain our banking relationships, that we can understand the Bahamas is not a money laundering jurisdiction. We're not a jurisdiction that's supporting terrorism financing. Yes, we're not trying to engage in base erosion, profit shifting, and facilitating ring fencing. All right, this is why we need the transparency. This is why we have the regulatory regimes. All right, so that people maintain their faith in us. All right. Let me see what this says. This person says, one, our reputation as a pirate country and money laundering and Ponzi scheme. See, I don't want to do that. Let's not do that, right? So let's call for transparency, call for accountability. But we have good regimes in place, all right? Will things happen? Certainly, all right? But we do have good regimes in place, all right? And we have a watchdog in place, but we want to make sure that that watchdog is alert and actually has teeth, all right, so that we can ensure that these sorts of things don't happen. But Bankman-Fried swung a lot of very, very smart people. On the smartest people in the world are supposed to be working on Wall Street, all right? And if he could swing them, it just goes to show. Like, he was running a serious shell game out here. All right. Now, as far as you putting your money in crypto, you do what you must. I'm not there yet. It's just not something. I just don't have the flexibility to like play around in that space right now. Although, you know, I was talking to one of my friends and he was saying, you know, you could just a couple hundred dollars you could play around with in there and see what happens, you know. But if these things keep happening in these crypto markets, there's going to be a problem. The exchanges will still exist because people are going to still trade in cryptocurrency. All right? But people may not be into it. Oh, I didn't know that. All right. Says the problem one is when our watchdog taking photo ops with the company owners. Says one, it will be interesting to see if the OECD will put stipulations on us for crypto. It may be an integral part of us getting off the list now. Yeah, they could do anything. I mean, I ain't gonna lie. They just might. They could make up whatever they want. All right. Now, I don't think it's going to affect our sovereign credit rating, as someone had suggested, but it could. It very well could be something that the OECD may be interested in. All right, we got to go to, well, the show's over. Okay, we got to go. You guys take care out here. I do not think I will be on air tomorrow, but certainly I do hope you have a great weekend. All right. Lord willing, I'll be back on Monday. Maybe back tomorrow, but I don't think I am. Have a great day, Bahamas.